There are multiple types of early pregnancy loss. It is important to learn which type you are having for optimal treatment. A biochemical pregnancy is a pregnancy that has been confirmed by a blood or urinary pregnancy test. Biochemical pregnancy loss is a pregnancy that is lost before it reaches the point where it can be seen on ultrasound. Biochemical pregnancy losses appear to be much different than clinical pregnancy losses. Clinical pregnancy losses occur after being verified with ultrasound. You should know the difference as it has important implications for your treatment. It is well known that clinical pregnancy losses are most commonly due to chromosome abnormalities. Testing embryos for chromosome abnormalities during IVF using PGS will reduce the number of clinical miscarriages. The older a woman gets, the bigger the decrease in clinical miscarriages that will occur with PGS. However, a number of studies have found that the use of PGS does not reduce the risk for biochemical pregnancies in IVF. Stated another way, most biochemical pregnancy losses are not due to chromosome abnormalities. Biochemical pregnancies are not just a result of fertility treatment. Many women become aware they've had a biochemical pregnancy because fertility doctors closely monitor them for the occurrence of a pregnancy. Sensitive blood tests can detect a biochemical pregnancy even before a woman misses her period. Women who are not involved with fertility treatments miss these very early pregnancy losses or attribute them to something else, like stress causing a period to be late. In 2015, doctors from Canada compared the rate of biochemical pregnancy losses in women doing IVF to women who conceived on their own without fertility treatment. They found that the biochemical pregnancy loss rate was actually a little lower in the IVF patients. This shows us that biochemical pregnancies are not just the result of fertility treatments. Doctors don't understand biochemical pregnancy losses. The vast majority of the studies that have been done on couples with miscarriage or recurrent miscarriage have specifically excluded couples with biochemical losses. So all of the recommendations for testing and treatment that you see about the antibodies and other problems do not apply to recurrent biochemical losses. The bottom line is that doctors do not understand recurrent pregnancy losses at all. And therefore, doing the same thing we do for recurrent clinical losses is not warranted at this time. Of course, as experts in reproduction, we hope we will learn more about the causes of biochemical pregnancies in the future. But as of right now, we are a little in the dark. We do know a lot about other types of pregnancy losses, which you can learn about in this playlist. If you like this video, remember to like this video. Have a question? Leave it in the comments. Click the link in the description to become a new patient, or subscribe to Infertility TV for new episodes weekly. It's like having a fertility specialist in your phone.